an old friend of mine who stood with us against the income tax 20 years ago, a man I always dreamt of serving with in the Senate, and a man who has arrived with fire and with proof that you can win in almost any district in Connecticut if you have the right message, my good friend Len Susio from Meredith. From Danbury, Connecticut, a stalwart conservative who has proven his worth, who has stood with us when we fought for 10th Amendment rights here in Connecticut, Mike McLaughlin. The ranking member of the Appropriations Committee on the Senate side, a fiscal conservative, a guy who has led the way in putting together a no-tax increase budget, Rob Kane. And finally, the leader of the Senate Republican caucus, my leader and a man who is showing leadership, who is working it out with the House, who's making it work for all of us, John McKinney. Are the legislators who are on your side. Do not lose hope and get that message out to the rest of them. It's great to rally, but make sure you know who your state representative and who your state senator is and give them the message. This fight is going to play out over the next couple of weeks. We're either going to beat this tax and save the state or we're going to keep going downhill. I don't know otherwise when we can stop it. So, keep your eyes open. You'll be hearing via the websites, via the emails, who it is that needs to get the word. We are taxed enough already. No new taxes for Connecticut. Thank you very much.
Breaking news, believe it or not, and they've run over from the legislative office building, and we're going to announce it right here. So we're going to have a teeny tiny break in our otherwise schedule. Let me introduce to you Representative Larry Cafero with some breaking news.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Unfortunately, the news I deliver is not good. As you sit out here, stand here in unison to talk at our state capitol and say no more taxes, no more taxes, as there are people of like mind that at this moment are here around the clock preparing an alternative that does not raise taxes. We just found out a half hour ago that the CEOs of the Hartford, the Aetna, Cigna, UTC and the Travelers have together signed a letter endorsing the governor's tax plan. Ignoring the effect on the middle class, ignoring the effect on small business, ignoring the hard work of every single man, woman, and child in this state, they are saying, to hell with you, we won't even wait for an alternative. We're endorsing $1.9 billion in additional taxes. That is irresponsible. Folks, may I just say this? Do not give up your fight. Do not let your voices be muffled. There are people that are listening to you and will keep going despite the Aetnas, the Hartfords, the Cignas, and the UTC. No new taxes. Thank you very much.